Now, right now, there are 2.2 million Americans behind bars. 2.2 million. We incarcerate people at a rate that is unequaled around the world.
Well, few Americans truly understand our prison system.
Arrest.
I'm gonna yank you out of here.
I'm gonna be saved. Do it now.
Charge.
I served a term of 2 years on that count as well.
Incarcerate. Repeat. This is how our criminal justice system is run, and overcrowding the jails, forming a class of largely African-American inmates who are stuck in the system.
The U.S. incarcerates more children than any other developed country. The vast majority of kids in juvenile jail don't commit a violent crime.
These are young people who made mistakes that aren't that different than the mistakes I made, the mistakes that a lot of you guys make.
For the convicted offenders, their sentences don't always end with release from prison.
You are now getting large numbers of prisoners who are actually being released heavily in debt, thousands of dollars in debt. There's no work, and if they can't pay that off, they go right back into prison.
Isolation has been widely condemned and considered harmful and unnecessary, yet many prisons across America still practice it.
Under the United Nations standards, 15 days or more is considered to be torture if you're kept in isolation that long. Often we will see people who have been in segregation for 15 years.
There's a long history of inequity in the criminal justice system in America. What has changed, though, is that in recent years, the eyes of more Americans have been opened to this truth. We can't close our eyes anymore.
It's pretty significant today that the government made a strong statement saying that, you know, we will not tolerate discrimination as it relates to school discipline. And I think it provides an opportunity for school districts to really be proactive about ensuring that discipline is reasonable, that it's consistent with the goals of keeping students in the classroom, and that we're returning to common sense discipline.
We've got an opportunity to make a difference at a time when overall violent crime rates have been dropping, at the same time as incarcerations last year dropped for the first time in 40 years.
Earlier in the year, 6,000 protesters across the state refused food, asked for their conditions to be more humane, and especially for the practice of solitary confinement to come to an end.
Colorado cut the number of people in solitary confinement. New Mexico also did it. They cut it by 25%. It significantly reduced the attacks against the staff. So it actually led to less violence.
When it comes to rehabilitating prisoners and reintegrating former inmates into society, you've got organizations that are doing extraordinary work. And you see what they've already accomplished and what more they're going to accomplish in the future. You cannot help but feel hopeful.
We need to change the culture of corrections in our society. It's not working. We all have to work together to reduce the prison population, save money, and save lives.
It's not too late. There are people who have gone through tough times. They've made mistakes. But with a little bit of help, they can get on the right path. And that's what we have to invest in. That's what we have to believe.